students, today we are going to start a new chapter. The name of the chapter is Memories of a Visit. So from the chapter's name only you can understand that these are some memories of someone related to their visit to a place somewhere. So let's begin. It was the month of April, springtime in France, and the best time to visit. I was going to visit my cousin, Supriya. I left Mumbai at 4 a.m. and arrived in France by 7 a.m. French time. I landed at the Charles de Gaulle Airport just outside Paris. Supriya was there to meet me. We got into a taxi and headed towards Paris. As we left the airport, I noticed there wasn't as much traffic as in Mumbai. I asked Supriya about France. It's about 1/4 the size of India, with a tiny population, she said. So now here, the author is telling that it was the month of April and it was the springtime in France and it was the best time to visit France. So I was going to visit with my cousin named Supriya. So the author is going to visit her cousin whose name is Supriya. So she is telling that she left Mumbai where she lived at 4 a.m. in the morning and she arrived in France by 7 a.m. French time. She is saying that she landed at the airport named Charles de Gaulle and just outside the Paris. Supriya was there, her cousin was there to greet her, meet her, and she is telling that they both got into the taxi and headed towards Paris. As we left the airport, the author is saying that she noticed that there wasn't much traffic as Mumbai. As Mumbai is a crowded place and there is so much of traffic, there was no traffic in France, in Paris. I asked Supriya about France. So she asked Supriya about France. It's about 1/4 the size of India with a tiny population, she said. So Supriya said that it is smaller than India and it is 1/4 of size of India with a small population. That means France is not crowded. There is plenty of room for everyone, I said jokingly. So the author said that means that France is not a crowded place and there is plenty of room for everyone, I said jokingly. Some large cities where there are factories are a bit crowded, but the country has almost everything that people need for a comfortable and happy life. The soil is rich and the sea borders much of France, so there are plenty of good vegetables, fruit, grains, meat and fish, she replied. So Supriya said that there are some large cities where there are factories that is bit crowded, but the country has almost everything that people need to live a comfortable and a happy life. The soil of France is also rich, the sea borders much of France are rich, so there are plenty of good vegetables also, fruit, grains also, meat and fish, she said. What else is special? I asked. So the author said that what else is special here in France? The French Alps, beautiful snow-capped mountains that people love to visit. The most beautiful French Alps-capped mountains are famous here, which people love to visit. There are also rivers and plains with luscious grass for grazing animals. There are many rivers and plains also with proper grass for grazing animals. Dairy farming is very popular because the French love cheese. It is an essential part of their diets. So dairy farming is also very popular here because French people love to eat cheese and it is an essential part of their diets. You will also find vineyards on sunny hillsides loaded with juicy grapes. You will also find vineyards where you can find juicy grapes. Most are harvested and pressed into wine for which France is famous. So France is famous for which most of them are harvested and they are pressed into wine. Most of the grapes are harvested and with the help of grapes, wine is made. And you already know about French fashion, France leads the world, follows. She laughed. So Supriya said that, and you already know about the French fashion, France leads, France always leads in fashion, and the world follows France fashion. So children, this is the half story about Memories of Visit. I will explain you another part of the story tomorrow. Until then, read this much part and try to understand it properly.